Today's video is about biography of Kenyan writer Ngugi wa Thiong'o. He is considered one of East Africa's most eminent literary figures. Since the early 1960s, he has produced a number of novels, plays, and critical essays, both in English and in Kenya's indigenous Gikuyu language, with a strongly political tone. His emergence as a writer was paralleled with Kenya's struggle to free itself from the legacy of colonialism. At times, he has very loudly and forcefully criticized the post-colonial leadership in his country. After a period in the late 1970s, when he was harassed and even jailed, Wa Thiong'o left the country permanently. So, let's start with his early life. Ngugi wa Thiong'o's original name is James Thiong'o Ngugi. He was born on January 5, 1938 in Kamiri-Aithu near Limuru in Kayamu district, Kenya, of Gikuyu descent. According to Wikipedia, his family was caught up in the Mau Mau uprising. His half-brother Mwangi was actively involved in the Kenyan Land and Freedom Army, and his mother was tortured at Kamiri-Aithu Home Guard Post. As a young boy, Ngugi went to Alliance High School and then went to study at Macquarie University in Kampala, Uganda. As a student, he attended the African Writers' Conference held at Macquarie in June 1962. In the following year, that is in 1963, he graduated from Macquarie University with a Bachelor's of Arts degree in English and went on to earn a second one from the University of Leeds in England. By this time, his first play, The Black Hermit, had already been produced in Nairobi, Kenya's capital. It was a part of a renewal in African culture taking place at that time. For Kenya's status as British possession that ended in December of 1963, when independence was firmly granted after more than a decade of unrest. Now, about his career and works. During the mid-60s, Ngugi wa Thiong'o taught at schools and wrote in his spare time. His first novel, Weep Not Child, written in 1964, fictionalizes a crucial period in Kenyan history of the Mau Mau emergency that lasted from 1952 to 1956. In this rebellion, Kenyans took arms against the English colonial government, which had relegated them to work as laborers or subsistence farmers. So, the novel won its young author the 1965's Dacre Festival of Negro Arts Prize. In 1965, while being in England, his second novel entitled The River Between came out, and A Grain of Wheat, which appeared 2 years later, marked the emergence of Fanonist Marxism. Ngugi's later work deal with the aftermath of the Mau Mau uprising and the changes that took place in Kenya and among Kenyans themselves as the country moved towards Independence Day. In 1967, Ngugi became a lecturer in English literature at the University of Nairobi. But he soon involved himself in an expanding African nationalist movement there and successfully campaigned to force the institution to change its English department into the Department of African Language and Literature. It was around this time that he abandoned his Christian name James in favor of Ngugi. Then he continued to teach at the university for 10 years while serving as a fellow in creativity writing at Macquarie. During this time, that is between 1970 to 1971, he was also a visiting lecturer at Northwestern University in the Department of English and African Studies for a year. In 1976, he co-wrote a play with a university colleague, Monsieur Githi Mugo, named The Trial of Dedan Kimathi, that won a competition. It was based on Kimathi, who had led the Mau Mau uprising, and Kimathi was executed for it by British colonial authorities in 1957. a year behind bars. They suggest that Gugi went to jail. But how? Let's see it. Gugi's novel, Petals of Blood, published in 1977, landed him in particular disfavor for its portrayal of a post-colonial Kenya torn apart by corruption and disillusionment, which cast much of the blame on the political leaders who had emerged since independence. At the time of this novel's publication, his play Angahikan Dina, which was later translated as I Will Marry You When I Want, co-authored with Gugi Wa Meriai, was banned as incendiary. This made him soon to become the victim of an official harassment campaign. His house was searched, his library of books seized, and he was jailed without trial for a year. Result of this, he lost his post at the University of Nairobi. In the midst of this troubling time, Wathiango announced that he would write only in Gikuyu or Swahili from this point onwards. His first book in Gikuyu was published abroad as Kethani Mathara Beni in 1980. He himself translated it 3 years later as Devil on the Cross. He viewed the decision to switch languages as crucial to his ultimate objective as a writer. He said in an interview with Research in African Literatures that when you use a language, you are also choosing an audience. When I used English, I was choosing English-speaking audience. Now I can use a story, word sounds, images, a myth, and not always explain because I can assume that Gikuyu readers are familiar with this. So from this, we surely come to know that his love towards his mother tongue and his efforts to keep the culture of Africa alive. Later, after his release in December 1978, he and his family was harassed, so he was forced to live in exile. Now about exile and the government hunt. In the early 1980s, Wathiango moved to England. He there continued to write both fiction and non-fiction, including works that have become staple for students of African literary criticism. In 1983, he published Barrel of a Pen, Resistance to Repression in Neo-Colonial Kenya. Then, in 1984, he was visiting professor at Bayreuth University, and the following year was writer in residence for the Borough of Islington in London. And he also studied film at Dramatiska University in Stockholm, Sweden. Then, in 1986, his Decolonizing the Mind, The Politics of Language in African Literature came out. And in the same year came The Writing Against Neocolonialism. His second novel, which was released in the same year in Gikuyu, entitled Matigarima Enjuroongi, attracted a great deal of controversy back in Kenya. Then, with his wife, Jerry, he founded a literary journal in the Gikuyu language, and though he had once delivered conference paper and wrote an important critical essay, he began using English again in the late 1980s in his academic career. In the early 1990s, he accepted a professorship at New York University's Africana Studies program. And in 1966, he was invited to deliver the prestigious Clarendon Lectures in English at Oxford University. The four essays were published the following year as Pen Points, Gun Points and Dream Towards a Critical Theory of Art and the State of Africa. Though he has not published any work of fiction since his children's Jamba Nene book in the late 1980s, Gugi continued to examine East African culture and politics in his scholarly work, and he has become the subject of several scholarly works by others. Though living far from his home, he continued to work towards leading Kenya into a new era. Then, between 1989 and 1992, Gugi was visiting professor of English and comparative literature at L University. In 1992, he was guest at the Congress of South African Writers and spent time in Zwet Township with M.C. Moala. That year, he became a professor of comparative literature and performance studies at New York University, where he held the Eric Maria Remarque Chair. His recent book includes Global Ethics, Theory and the Politics of Knowing, published in 2012, and Something Torn and New, and African Renaissance, a collection of essays published in 2009. Makes the argument for the crucial role of African languages in the recession of African memory. In 2019, his book, The Perfect Nine, originally written and published in Gikuyu as Kenda Mayuru, was translated into English by him for its 2020 publication, and it is a reimagining in epic poetry of his people's origin story. It was longlisted for the International Booker's Prize, with Googie becoming the first nominee as both author and translator of the same book. Here, there are some awards and honors. As there is nothing to explain it, so just pause and go through this list and you will understand it. Now at the end, currently, Gugiwa Thiang'o holds a professorship of comparative literature and English at the University of California, Irvine, and continues to produce an impressive body of work dealing with Kenyan history, politics and culture. He wrote in his Moving the Center, The Struggle for Cultural Freedom that, "Writing has always been my way of reconnecting myself to the landscape of my birth and upbringing." He continued, "Not surprisingly, the natural landscape dominates the East African literary imagination. This awareness of the land as the central actor in our lives distinguishes East African literature from others in the continent, and it certainly glooms large in my own writing." So that's it for this video. I have listed his awards, honors, and his works collectively at one place, so check the link in the description to know more. Hope you liked the video. I tried to be straight at the point in minimum time. And if you do liked it, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share with friends too. Thank you.